वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल द चिल्ड्रन. यस बेटा, वी वर ऑन पेज नंबर 29. वी आर रीडिंग द चैप्टर द एनिमी एंड दीज आर द पॉइंट्स व्हिच वी विल बी कवरिंग टुडे. क्लियर? सो करेक्टर्स आर रिटन ओवर देयर. डॉक्टर सदाओ, द प्रोटैगनिस्ट सदाओ होकी, अ जापानीज डॉक्टर हु इज वेरी प्रोफिशिएंट. हना, wife of Dr. Sadao, and then we have Tom, who is the American prisoner and escapist of war. Yomi is the, you can say, house help of Dr. Sadao and Hana. So you can say basically she takes care of the kids also, and she is cook in the house also. And there is one more character, Gardner, that will be coming in this. Fine. So we have read so far when they found somebody was staggering out of the ocean and fell on the sand, and then they realized that it was a American prisoner and he was badly wounded, and they were in dilemma whether to give treatment to this as a doctor's first duties on humanitarian ground to treat the patient, or they should give this or hand over this man to the authorities, because World War II was going on, Japan and America, opposite countries at war. So they decided firstly to treat him, and then after that, after giving treatment to him, they will be handing him over to the authorities, or let's see what they do. So now he was so dirty that Hana was having feeling of disgust now, that he was so filthy because since so many days he has not been able to take bath, or hair were long and blood was flowing out of wounds, tattered clothing. So, and they kept that young man, that young prisoner, into the room of their father, fine, who is no more now. So we are on page 29, last lines only. Sadao considered a moment. Let it be so, he agreed. You tell Yumi and I will tell the others. Now they decided that they will be taking the help of the servants. They will be informing them that yes, we have given shelter to an enemy. But as he's wounded, after treatment, when he'll be fine, we'll hand him over to the higher authorities. So both of them decided that you tell Yumi and I will be telling other servants. But the utter pallor of the man's unconscious face. So let me share the screen for you all, those sitting at home. Yes, beta, any doubt is there? You can ask me, and I'm going to share the screen with you all. We are on page 29. So this is the paragraph. Clear? But the utter pallor of the man's unconscious face moved him first to stoop and feel his pulse. It was faint, but it was there. So he firstly checked as a doctor whether his pulse is working or not, whether he's alive or dead. So his pulse was working, and he could feel his pulse. It was fainted. Fine. He put his hand against the man's cold breast. The heart was also alive. He could, feel that heartbeat. And then, Hana, he will die unless he is operated on, Sadao said, considering the question is whether he will not die anyway. So they decided that this is the emergency case, they have to operate upon this man. Hana cried out in fear, don't try to save him. What if he should live? So I told you the next point is, Hana was apprehensive about Tom's treatment. So she is now again, after bringing that man, she had also given consent. Now she's saying, what if he will be alive? Then again, we will be in state of cure. So she's apprehensive. What should we do? And what if he should die? Sadao replied. So when Hannah says, if he will be alive, what will we do? So on this, Dr. Sadao replied, at this moment, beta, Dr. Sadao is quite clear about his decision. You know, Hannah had made this decision, but now she is again repenting that why we brought this man here. This is very controversial situation. But Dr. Sadao is now keeping his duty at the foremost place. So he says, what if he should die? He stood gazing down on the motionless man. This man must have extraordinary vitality or he would have been dead by now. So doctor says, this man is quite brave and, you know, having great immunity system and vitality. Because after getting the bullet in his back, he ran away and he fell into the water. And after getting, you know, stuck to many, getting hit into many rocks, then also he's alive. Clear? So he's saying he's man of vitality and marna hota to kab ka mar jata. But then he was very young, perhaps not yet 25 even. So he was very young, less than 25. You mean die from operation? Hannah asked. Yes, Sadao said. Hannah considered this doubtfully. And when she did not answer, Sadao turned away. At any rate, something must be done with him. So this is the decision Dr. Sadao made, that something should be done with this man. And at first, he must be washed. So first thing is, he says, he's so filthy, so dirty. Before operating upon, what I'm supposed to do, I will be, we need to wash this man first. She did not wish to be left alone with the white man. He was the first she had seen since she left America. And now he seemed to have nothing to do with those whom she had known there. Here he was her enemy, a menace. Menace means beta, threat. Menace means threat, living or dead. So she is saying whether he is living, whether he is dead, it is a threat to our life. So she is again hesitant of treating this man. She turned to the nursery and called Yumi. So she called. Nursery is where the children are kept fine. So she called Yumi, that lady who takes care of the children. But the children heard her voice and she had to go in for a moment and smile at them and play with the baby boy, now nearly 3 months old. So you can very well imagine that she's having just a young baby, very small baby, 3 month old boy. And when she goes there, she just plays a bit with the children. And she says, over the baby's soft black hair, she motioned with her mouth, Yumi, come with me. I will put the baby to bed, Yumi replied, he is ready. Ready means he's ready to sleep. So Yumi says, ma'am, he's about to sleep. Let me put him to the bed and I will join you. And she went with Yumi into the bedroom next to the nursery and stood with the boy in her arms, while Yumi spread the sleeping quilts on the floor and laid the baby between them. So both of them helped in laying the baby on the bed. Then Hannah led the way quickly and softly to the kitchen. The two servants were frightened at what their master had just told them. Fine. This was decided that lady, that Yumi, who was the house help, Hannah will be informing her. And Dr. Sadao will be informing other servants, other male servants of the house, that we have kept an enemy at home. So while seeing Hannah in the kitchen, other servants were, you know, very shell-shocked of what they have heard. The old gardener, underline, this is another character. The old gardener, who was also a house servant, pulled the few hairs on his upper lip. So he was so, you know, people start biting their lips, they start reacting by showing their facial expression. So that was the way they were reacting by listening to this reality. The master ought not to heal the wound of this white man, he said bluntly to Hannah. So when Hannah entered the kitchen, that gardener, who was also playing the part of house help, he was adamant. He says that why you have given shelter to a white man, our master should not help him at all. Then what happened? The white man ought to die. First he was shot, then the sea caught him and wounded him with her rocks. If the master heals what the gun did and what the sea did, they will take revenge on us. This is the statement given by an illiterate person. See, you know, even after being educated, we people still believe. What is the statement of the gardener? Ki, this man has to die. Why? Because pehle usko gunshot laga, and then he fell into the water and he got hit into many rocks. It means God wants him to die. So he, this is his destiny. Agar Dr. Sadao usko bacha lega, Tobar already was about to die. So nature will take revenge upon him. Fine? So aise jo vehm hote hain, conservative thinking, you can say, fine, and that approach should be avoided. But they are the servants in the house, nobody can stop them to comment. So that's why they are commenting upon the actions of their masters. I will tell him what you say, Hana replied courteously. He was being rude here, but Hana was very courteous. Yahi to difference hota hai, educated person and illiterate people. So Hana was very educated and very patient lady. She said, okay, I will tell him. But she herself was also frightened, although she was not superstitious as the old man was. So old man is superstitious. Who is the old man? Gardener of the house, you must know. Could it ever be well? Test sabne diya tha kal? Koi reh to nahi gaya? Make sure, fine. Could it ever be well to help an enemy? Nevertheless, she told Yumi to fetch the hot water and bring it to the room where the white man was. So, though Hana was also scared, so she called Yumi that bring hot water, which was required to be, wash that boy. She went ahead and slid back the partitions. Sadao was not yet here. Yumi, following, put down her wooden bucket. Then she went over to the white man. When she saw him, her thick lips folded themselves into stubbornness. I have never washed a white man, she said, and I will not wash so dirty a one now. The statement given by Yumi, fine, who takes care of the kids in the house. When she was brought in by Hana in the same room where prisoner was lying, she thought that Yumi will help us. But she was also hesitant. Straight away, she denied that I have never washed a white man. See, otherwise, suppose if it had, it would have been another person from Japan, then they would have given their services. See, so this is the psychology of human beings, that if a person from opposite country in the same situation, we are not ready to help. So she straight away denies to help Hana. Hana cried at her severely. You will do what your master commands you. So Hana was feeling very bad that firstly the servant, that gardener, you know, he was rude in the kitchen, and now Yumi also behaving badly. So she again started shouting. Who shouted? Hana. Hana said, this is the command of your master, I'm telling you. There was so fierce a look of resistance upon Yumi's round, dull face that Hana felt unreasonably afraid. After all, if the servant should report something that was not as it happened. So after giving command to Yumi, Hana was again frightened. She thought, I am scolding these people. What if they go to higher authorities? They will report about us that they are giving shelter to an enemy. What will happen then? So Hana got scared at this moment after seeing the expressions of house help Yumi. Clear? Any doubt, beta, to anyone? Koi doubt to nahi hai kisi ko? Children sitting at home, beta. Yes, send me the expressions that it's clear to all of you. Let me check. Amitosh, are you there? Kapil Luther, are you there? Jo kabhi kabhi aate hain ye students. If you won't send me the reaction, it means you are not present there. Okay, Amitosh. Let's continue then. Yes, on this page we are. So then what happened? Very well, she said with dignity. You understand, we only want to bring him to his senses. so that we can turn him over as a prisoner. So she explains again to Yumi. Who is explaining? Hana. Hana is saying that Yumi, listen, after treating this man, we will hand him over as a prisoner only. I will have nothing to do with him. Yumi said, I am a poor person and it is not my business. Even then Yumi did not, you know, agree. She says, I am a poor person. I don't want to get into it. You know, everybody was scared ki hamara nahin na aajai bich mein. Then please, Hana said gently, return to your own work. Then Yumi, that work, there was no choice only. Hana thought Yumi will help me in washing this man and Dr. Sadao will perform operation. And Dr. Sadao was busy in preparation of operation only. There are a lot of things required. So she straight away said no. So Hana said, okay, if you don't want to help, you can go and continue with your work. At once, Yumi left the room, but this left Hana with a white man alone. She might have been too afraid to stay had not her anger at Yumi's stubbornness now sustained her. Stupid Yumi, she muttered fiercely. Is this anything but a man and a wounded, helpless man? So she is talking to herself that what if she will help this wounded, helpless man here? So in the conviction of her own superiority, she bent impulsively and untied the knotted rugs that kept the white man covered. So she was in that stubbornness that, okay, main apne aap kar lungi. Ye jo gussa hota hai na, ki I will do it on my own. In that anger, she started, you know, opening the knots in which that man was tied up. When she had his bare breast, she dipped the small clean towel that Yumi had brought into the steaming hot water and washed his face carefully. So Hana herself started cleaning that man. The man's skin, though rough with exposure, was of a fine texture and must have been very blonde when he was a child. Blonde here means white. So as he was American, he was a white man, he was very fair complexion, the boy. While she was thinking these thoughts, though not really liking the man better now, he was no longer a child. She kept on washing him until his upper body was quite clean. But she dared not turn him over. Where was Sadao? Now her anger was ebbing. And she was anxious again and rose, wiping her hands on the wrong towel. Then lest the man be chilled, she put the quilt over him. After cleaning the upper body and face, because operation has to be operated on the lower back where the bullet is there, right side of the back, and she did not turn that man over. And she was now full of anger. Firstly, what Yumi did, and secondly, she was searching for her husband, Dr. Sadao. He was not there. He had been about to come in when she called. She started calling him softly, Sadao. His hand had been on the door and now he opened it. She saw that he had brought his surgeon's emergency bag and that he wore his surgeon's coat. You have decided to operate? She cried. Yes, he said shortly. He turned his back to her and unfolded a sterilized towel upon the floor of Tokonoma alcove. Tokonoma is a bit of niche likha hua hai. You can see the footnotes, a niche or an eclogue in a Japanese home for displaying of flower arrangements. Here, it is a piece of art only. So what he does, whatever equipments he was having at home, you have to sterilize your utensils, you know, equipments, whatever you're using. So he brought all the emergency equipments with him and he started the process and he started lying his instruments on a towel. Fetch towels, he said. She went obediently. But how anxious now to the linen shelves and took out the towels. There ought also to be old pieces of matting so that the blood would not ruin the fine floor covering. She went out to the back veranda where the gardener kept strips of matting with which to protect delicate shrubs on cold nights and took an armful of them. So he started giving instructions to his wife, though hesitant. Hana kept on following the instructions of her husband obediently because she did not have any choice. So she went to the garden. She brought all the coverings, jo extra aapke ghar pe kuch covers pade hote hain when rain comes or in the time of, you know, rugs and useless things, but we use it for cleaning purpose. So she started bringing those sheets, which was required during the operation. But when she went back into the room, she saw this was useless. The blood had already soaked through the packing in the man's wound and had ruined the mat under him. So when she comes back, already the mat of their bed was already ruined. Bloodshed was there. "Oh, the mat," she cried. "Yes, it is ruined now," Sadao replied, as though he did not care. "Help me to turn him," he commanded her. So he was not bothering about the mat and bed and mattress now. He was bothering about the life of his patient. So he commanded to his wife, "Give me the help. Let's turn this man over." She obeyed him without a word, and he began to wash the man's back carefully. So Dr. Sadao himself started washing the back of the man. "Yumi would not wash him," she said. "Did you wash him then?" Sadao asked, not stopping for a moment his swift, concise movements. So Dr. Sadao is continuously washing and cleaning the back of the man. And she said, "Yumi did not help me." He told her husband, and he said, "Okay, then you did it." She said, "Yes." He did not seem to hear her, but she was used to his absorption when he was at work. So he was a very, you know, some people are workaholics, or they get absorbed into their works into that way. Doctors should be like that only, because if they will not concentrate on the work they're doing, they will do some misleading only. So though he was listening to his wife, but his concentration was directly on the patient. She wondered for a moment if it mattered to him what was the body upon which he worked so long, as it was for the work he did. So we are on next page now, beta. This is the page. You are having books at home, so you need not even look at the screens. Fine. So this is the picture where they turned over the man, and now they are going to operate upon it. If it mattered to him, what was the body upon which he worked so long as it was for the work he did so excellently. You will have to give the anesthetic if he needs it, he said. What is an anesthetic? Anesthetic is a medicine which is given before surgery, and it makes the person unconscious. Sometimes, you know, the person does not remain in his senses. So she was, and you know, there is giving anesthesia. This is not the job of a doctor even, you know that. Proper, before surgery, a proper specialized authority comes over there, a nurse or a doctor. And being an anesthetic, you can say, physician is different degree. So there are specialized, this is if a dose increases, the person might die also. And if a person gets lesser dose, again, the chances that while operating upon, he wakes up. So the dose add past the age of the person, patient, and weight of the patient. It is very tedious thing to do, fine? So he says, because Hana was proficient in giving anesthesia. So that's why he says, you will have to give him anesthesia if needs it. She repeated blankly, "I, but never have I." So she has not given earlier, fine? She was never into this circumstance earlier. So she said, "Maine kabhi diya hi nahi." "It is easy enough," he said impatiently. He said, "This is easy, don't get scared." He was talking out the packing now. He started taking out the equipments, and the blood began to flow more quickly. He peered into the wound with the bright surgeon's light fastened on his forehead. You can see in the picture that a light is there on his head, forehead, because they need a lot of, you know, lights and all. That's why operation theater people lights hoti. They were not having any equipment at home. So usne apne tie kiya hua hai that in case of emergency, agar light chali jaye to in that case, so a battery operated light he was having on over his head, fine. So he said with cool interest, "The bullet is still there. Now I wonder how deep this rock wound is. If it is not too deep, it may be that I can get the bullet. But the bleeding is not superficial. He has lost much blood." At this moment, Hana choked. He looked up and saw her face, the color of sulfur. Doctor was so engrossed in cleaning the man that he did not realize that, you know, everybody cannot see the operation going on. And Hana was not a proficient doctor who has operated upon people. Dr. Sadao has done earlier surgeries. So Hana was about to puke, you know, that puking. So she was having that feeling of disgust
that what my husband is doing and putting hands into the body and cleaning and wounds and blood flowing out. She was, you know, not, don't faint, he said sharply. He did not put down his exploring instrument. If I stop now, the man will surely die. See, the brave situation, the brave part on the, you can say, Dr. Sadao, he's scolding his wife. Don't faint to hear by seeing this scene. Help me. This is the need. If I will not attend, he will die. She clapped her hands to her mouth and leaped up and ran out of the room. She was about to puke only. So what she could do? She just pressed both hands on her mouth and puking and usko vomiting aa raha, and she ran out of the room. And but he went on with his work. Dr. Sadao did not stop. He did not think my wife is puking and not feeling well. I should see and go out. He was knowing ki okay, puking hai, vomiting hai, she'll be fine after that. My concentration should be on my patient. It will be better for her to empty her stomach, he thought. He thought this is better. When you are feeling this, one should even vomiting is sometime good. It cleanses your system. He had forgotten that, of course, she had never seen an operation. So he forgot that my wife was not there in that operation theater. She was not a surgeon. Surgeons are different, fine. But her distress and his inability to go to her at once made him impatient and irritable with this man who lay like dead under his knife. So doctor was also getting irritated about this situation. This man, he thought, there is no reason under heaven why he should live. Unconsciously, this thought made him ruthless and he proceeded swiftly. In his dream, the man moaned, but Sadao paid no heed except to mutter at him. So now this boy was moaning with pain. He was not in consciousness, but he was moaning with pain. But doctor was just considered about treating him. Groan, he muttered. Groan if you like. I'm not doing this for my own pleasure. In fact, I do not know why I'm doing it. See, doctor is frustrated. Why he's frustrated here? Can anyone tell me why he's frustrated? Because he didn't want to do it firstly, but after he decided, like, let's do it, his own family is getting affected. His wife started puking. House help is not helping. Fine. So this is very situation of dilemma for him. And he is, you know, scolding the man while operating. So he's saying that due to you, I'm just doing this. I do not know why I'm doing it. The door opened and there was Hana again. Where is the anesthetic? She asked in a clear voice. See, after vomiting in the garden area, she again came back. That shows the spirit. And she asked, where is the anesthesia? Sadao motioned with his chin. It is as well that you came back, he said. This fellow is beginning to stir. Stir means to move. So this was the right time Hana came back because he was coming back into his consciousness and they needed anesthesia. Any doubt to anyone, beta? Clear to all of you? So we'll continue tomorrow. It's a quite a lengthy chapter, but we'll be... maybe I'll be telling you about some extra class. If not possible tomorrow, the next day and all, right? So be there only.